was. She was plump and dark with sparkling eyes, and she always wore dark gloves on her hands, even indoors. He went out of his way to meet her, and they often bumped into each other on the street, and they also possess the solid gold hand that she wore underneath her glove. He courted the widow with every stratagem known to him. Flowers, trips to the park, trips to the theater, gifts, compliments, and he won her heart. Within a month, they were standing in front of the minister, promising to love one another until death parted them. Within another month, he was a widow. So easy, a slow poison administered daily to resemble a wasting disease. No one, not his wife, not the doctors, nor her friends would notice. No one suspected murder. And the night after the funeral, he slept with the golden hand under his pillow. It was a dark night. Clouds covered the moon, and the wind was whistling down the chimney and rattling the shutters of the townhouse. He was deeply asleep when the door in his room slammed open with a loud bang, and a wild wind whipped around the room, scattering papers and books and clothing and table coverings every which of way. He sat up, startled by the sudden white light bobbing slowly into the room. Before his eyes, the light slowly grew larger, taking on the shape of his dead wife. She was was missing one arm. Where is my golden hand? She moaned, her dark eyes blazing with red fire. Give me my golden hand. He tried to speak, but his mouth was shut. It was dry of fear. He could only make soft gasping noises. The glowing phantom moved closer to him, her once lovely face twisted into a hideous green mask. You stole my life. You stole my hand. Give me back my golden hand. The dead wife howled. The noise rose louder, higher and higher, and the phantom pulsed with a strident green light that smoked her eyes, making them water. He cowered back against his pillows, and the hard shape of the golden hand pressed against his back. And then he felt the golden hand twitch underneath him as the mangled green phantom that had been his wife swooped down upon him, pressing his face against the pillow in a suffocating green cloud. He tried to scream, but it was cut off. Suddenly, a terrible pressure against his throat, cutting off his breath. The world went black. The next morning, when the housemaid came into the room with her master's morning cup of tea, she found him lying dead on the floor with the golden hand on his throat. How did y'all like that story? Kind of spooky. Candidate. up the road.